why I'm here, and you, because many people always ask me, why are you here in Ireland? People hear about amazing things about Costa Rica, and they just wonder why I'm here. But so the talk of today is called Una exploración a lo desconocido, an exploration of the unknown. So why did I decide to call it that? Because usually when we think about a country, something that's far away, we usually think about only what maybe the media has portrayed, what we've seen, but I don't want to just talk about what you can normally Google of Costa Rica, but I want to give maybe a full picture about a country, about Costa Rica. So I'll be... So as everything, there's always two sides of a story, two sides of a coin. So when you hear about Costa Rica, we usually hear about, well, I'll just ask everyone here. When you usually think about Costa Rica, what do you think?
Flora.
What comes to your mind?
Flora.
Mm-hmm. Coffee.
Pineapples.
Pineapples. Yeah, usually when even if you've never been there, you haven't heard much about it, but you might think about a paradise, drinking coconut water and a mojito under a palm tree, enjoying the beach. I'm not trying to say that Costa Rica isn't this, it is that, but it's a lot more. And so what I want to do is show the positive sides and the negative sides, so the full picture. So where is Costa Rica? Costa Rica is not an island. Costa Rica is not Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico is on the Caribbean. It's an island which belongs to the United States. Costa Rica is an independent country and it's in Central America. So Costa Rica is not in South America, it's not in North America, but it's in Central America. Central America starts from Mexico down to Panama. So this is a nice illustration I found from Rubinky Art. It's quite a lot of images in there, but just to show a bit of why, we'll talk about why Costa Rica is very biodiverse, and one of the reasons is that it has a Caribbean Sea and it has a Pacific Ocean, and they're quite close to each other. So Costa Rica is a narrow country. If you can travel 4 hours from the Caribbean to the Pacific Ocean, but it's quite narrow, and there's right in the middle of the country there's this massive mountains. So we'll see later on how that affects, and it just creates a lot of biodiversity. As you can see, there's 17 volcanoes. 10 of them have been active since the last 15 years. Loads of surfing beaches, and yeah, we'll talk a little bit more about that on the next slide. Oh, sorry. Thank you. Sorry. Not just to geographically. It borders on the south of Panama and on the north with Nicaragua. Entonces, un poco de datos generales acerca del país. Costa Rica tiene una superficie de 51.100 kilómetros al cuadrado. Es un poquito más pequeño que Irlanda. Irlanda tiene 70.000 70.000 kilómetros al cuadrado. So Costa Rica is slightly a little bit smaller than Ireland. La capital es San José, el idioma oficial es español. Muchas de las personas hablan inglés, más que todo en los últimos años, porque el país es muy turístico, entonces las personas aprenden el inglés por esas razones. Pero hay 7 idiomas indígenas. Esto es algo que muchas personas... piensan que Latinoamérica solo se habla español, pero no, todavía hay muchas lenguas indígenas todavía que existen. Y la población es de casi 5 millones. La población es igual que la de Irlanda. So the population is the same as Ireland. So the country is a little bit smaller, and population, the last census, it was 4 million, almost 5 million. So probably this year's census, 2016, it will be 5 million, probably the same as Ireland. La religión oficial es el catolicismo. Eso principalmente porque Costa Rica, como toda Latinoamérica, fue colonizado por España. España trajo su religión a Latinoamérica. Y educación básica es obligatoria, es gratis, y la tasa de alfabetización es del 94.9%. Más adelante vamos a ver un poco más de datos acerca de eso. Tropical. Costa Rica is on the part of the world where it's tropical. When I was small and I would see pictures of maybe Hawaii, of the Philippines, Malaysia, I would think, oh, but it looks just like Costa Rica, it can't be, it has to be a picture from Costa Rica. But I didn't know that there were other countries in the world that were tropical, such as we have Bolivia, Hawaii, Cameroon, Ecuador, India, Malaysia, Myanmar, Republic of Congo, and many more. So all these countries, you'll see this pretty much the same vegetation, the exuberant greens and different tones of tonalities of greens, a lot of water. So you can talk about tropical rainforest or tropics when you talk about more than 2,000 millimeters of rain per year. We're going to talk about a bit more about that, of how much rainfall we have in Costa Rica, opposed to Ireland as well, just an interesting talk there. So I have the first video. So I've been talking, you know, a little bit just general facts about Costa Rica and about its nature, so I just have a video here for you. For the ones that have never been there, and just to get a mental image of what the country could look like. Sorry, this isn't as big as it should. So this is the highlights of nature. Thank you. because it has 5,000 millimeters of rainfall every year. So to get an idea of how much that is, Ireland per year gets 750 to 1,000 per year. So that's a lot. So if you think that if Ireland rains a lot, then Costa Rica is a lot more. The west coast of Ireland gets around 2,000 per year. So you may be wondering, okay, but I have the impression that in Ireland it rains every day. So it does rain a lot, but it doesn't rain as much. So it's like the little drizzle. But in Costa Rica, they're like raindrops that are just massive. So the dry season is pretty much now, December. Well, it's finishing. It started in December, now it's finishing May. And the rainy season is June and till November. So we wouldn't have seasons. We wouldn't have the summer, the autumn, and the winter, but just dry season and rainy season. So or it rains a lot or it doesn't rain. But although it can rain a lot in rainy season, you will see the sun. It comes out maybe every day, at least every day. So it does make a difference. And as Helen was saying, it's humid, it's hot, so it makes a difference. It's not the damp cold. And if you combine rainfall and sun, you have a really green country, loads of animals and loads of nature. And many people call it the garden of Central America. So a couple of interesting facts. Because of what we're talking, it has 5% of the world's biodiversity. So if in the world there were only 100 animals, 5 of these animals would be in Costa Rica. 25% of the country's land area is in protected national parks and protected areas. So really, Ed, you go to Costa Rica and everywhere you are, that they say, oh, this is a national park, this is a protected area, they're just everywhere. And it actually has, Costa Rica has the largest percentage of protected areas in the world. So it's the country that protects, that has more protected areas. The developing world average is 13%, so about 13% protected, and the developed world, they'll have an average of 8%. So Costa Rica is the developing world and has 25%. So we have this global green economy index, and basically what that does, it measures how well each country performs in 4 key dimensions. The first one is leadership in climate change, second one is efficiency sectors, third is markets and investment, and the fourth is natural capital. So it ranks the third. And in the sustainable tourism category, it's the first one. 93% of the country's energy comes from renewable sources, mainly hydroelectric. So this is water, because there's loads of rivers and waterfalls, so there's a lot of this going on. It's ranked as the happiest country by the New Economics Foundation. If you're interested a bit more, like about these measurements, we can talk at the end, and I can give you maybe some sources to look that up. So that in the Happy Planet Index, it's a global measure of sustainable well-being. So it basically, what it does is it ranks countries on how many long and happy lives they produce per unit of environmental input. So Ireland is in number 73. So they take a sample of 151 countries, and Ireland is in 73, and Costa Rica is on number 1. Of course, you know, these are just quantitative measurements. They're after that qualitative, it's not a sample of everyone, so you know, you have to be a bit, you can't just completely trust them. But if you're interested, I can share a bit more about this at the end, and you can do your own research and decide what you believe. An interesting fact is that since 1948 it has no army, one of the first countries in the world that abolished its army. At the time it was a very progressive, for its time, very progressive president. He basically said that the money wasn't going to go into killing people, but it was going to go into education, into healthcare, education, and environmental protection. So because of this, Costa Rica is a very different country compared to many other Central American countries. While at the time in the 1980s, all the Central American countries are all going through dictatorships. That's why there was a big division between the rich and the poor, a lot of oppression. Costa Rica didn't go through all this. A lot of its money was going into education, sending its people off to study, and that made a difference, and that's why Costa Rica is what it is today. Smoking is subject to some of the most restrictive regulations in the world. I don't know how it is here in Ireland, but at the moment in Costa Rica they're very, very strict. A couple of years ago, you would go in the pubs and everyone was smoking, and for now they're really, really strict. In public space, you can't smoke in universities or in educational places. You can't smoke, so it's quite restrictive. And it's among one of the blue zones of the world, and we'll just talk a little bit about that on the next slide. Let's see if that works. Sorry, can you go in the So I'm going to show maybe we can go on the outside of the next slide, then I'll show the video. So this is just to show you the website, the Happy Planet Index. If you're interested, maybe later on you can go into that. And basically what it does is, there's just three measurements, and then they multiply the two of them and then divide it between the other. Don't remember the exact order, but it's experience well-being. So they do interview people, they ask them. I think when you go in here, you can see all the questions that they ask. Then they multiply by the life expectancy, I think, and then they divide it into the ecological footprint. So, blue zones. Most of you probably already know about blue zones. If you don't, really, really interesting, quite fascinating. It was just a project from National Geographic, I think in maybe 5 years ago. They just hired this researcher to go all around the world and research where people in the world would live longer and why. So it was extensive research, and at the end, the results were five countries. One is Nicoya, Costa Rica. We're going to talk a little bit about that. Loma Linda, California. Sardinia, Italy. Italia, Greece. And Okinawa, Japan. So what makes people live long? It's quite interesting if you think about the places that came out that people live longer. They're all sunny and dry places. Why does dryness help you to live longer? And, well, just just like a personal little fact, like last year that I was living in Sligo, it was, you know, we had a horrible summer, it was very damp, and I just couldn't wake up early in the mornings. I'm usually an early morning person. And it was probably like, and I was living in a really damp house, unfortunately, a damp flat, and I just felt drained, I had no energy. So then I was reading about this, and I thought, it makes sense if you live in a dry place. And then I was thinking about my brother. He says that every time he's in a dry place, he's always full of energy. So I thought, oh, it's quite interesting. And when you read about the blue zones, the researcher doesn't talk about why the dryness. He does talk about the sun, that the sun just makes you feel happier, and it's better for your health as well. So we will see this video here.
Maybe the Mini 100 is a popularity contest after all. In 2006, during Blue Zone's first visit to Costa Rica, we met 99-year-old Panchita. In America, only one in seven women over 100 can even take care of themselves. Panchita, now in the world, she's a good star. Thank you.
seems really happy, but she's really poor, and you can see she has a dirt floor and not a lot of money, but that's not what gives her happiness. One of the common denominators of all these five countries of why they lived on these, they work the land, so they're physically active. As you can see, that she'd wake up at 4 in the morning, she'd be cooking and cutting the grass, and so all these people here, they work the land or just be physically active, and as I mentioned, they're so close social networks, and in Costa Rica, families are really important, especially in the countryside. In Ecuador would be quite countryside, so families are still close, and religion, people are very spiritual there still, so that can help people live longer, I suppose. So now we talked about the positive sides of Costa Rica, positive sides, but as you all know, we don't have a perfect, we still don't have paradise, and there's no perfection yet. So I just want to talk a little bit about interesting facts, negative, but I think we should all know. And one of the reasons is pineapples. So why pineapples? I bought this one in Tesco the other day, and I don't know if you probably noticed, but they all come from Costa Rica. So yeah, it's a could be a normal thing for everyone here to slice a pineapple and just eat it, but we don't usually think what's behind the production of pineapples. So just to have an introduction of what I'm talking about. Have a little video here.
Look in any supermarket today, and you'll find pineapples have become the latest weapon in a price war.
Sorry, this is just a video from The Guardian. The Guardian, in 2010, they sent this lady, I forgot her name, to Costa Rica just to research a bit about the pineapple production in Costa Rica.
Look in any supermarket today, and you'll find pineapples have become the latest weapon in a price war. There are discounts everywhere, two for the price of one, and half price special offers. But what's the true cost of a cut price pineapple? 3/4 of pineapples on European shop shelves come from plantations in Costa Rica, most of them by one of the tiny number of multinationals that dominate the trade. Created thousands of jobs, but conditions are often so poor and tough that most of the